welcome to the 17th episode of QuakeLive Plays, brought to you by me, DDK. And today, actually, I played a bunch of duels, and it's been, maybe even like a year. It may even have been close to, I think maybe like 10 months since I really played some duels. But the last couple of days, I was dueling a little bit. And I asked Etty for some games, and we played quite a few games, and I played with some various other opponents too. But this was a game which, when I was playing it, it kind of struck out. You know, some elements of it kind of struck out at me, and I was like, I should make a video on that and talk about some of those things. So we're gonna go with this game. So it's me versus Etty, and I guess this can qualify maybe as community plays. I don't know. Either way, everyone silence. So let's jump in this. So at the start, I'm getting the red armor. So definitely, I'm full of mistakes. So I wanted to get straight on to some pressure, not realizing that Etty already had the rocket launcher and can just quickly escape. So I actually lost a lot of time, kind of putting myself not necessarily out of control, because I do have some decent positioning. And there, I try to go to pressure Etty. Problem is, I've got to be careful not to allow Etty onto the red first. So you can see we both kind of get here. I get here a little bit quicker, and the positioning is a little bit better considering what we both have going for us, because I can drop quite easily onto the red mid-fight like that, and so that gives me a slight advantage, and you can see it also gives me the frag, so that's pretty nice. So now it's about thinking about the mega, but I can't really get there in time. I don't want to really take much damage, so I'm just trying to use the pillar here to maybe see if I can catch Etty out, and got a really nice engagement there, and it makes me think that I can pressure, and you can see here, I'm trying to like make it look like I'm moving forwards, but really I'm not. I'm going to back away again so that he'll pop out to try to shoot a rocket to get a really good shot to see me, make it direct and catch me close range with the rocket. And in reality, I'm trying to bait him into that so I can just stand back and LG. That's kind of the idea. And then I decide that I want to go for a quick rocket jump to get positioning onto the yellow. And the yellow wasn't even up, so it's kind of a mistake. Had the yellow been up, that's actually quite a cool little move. But now I've kind of given away position on the rest of the map. So this is a spot where I'm like, okay, I know that I don't have any items, and I have some weapons though. I do have a bit of a weapon advantage, I believe. So I should just chill and try to get some damage, play some positions. So that's what I'm trying to do here. And missed the first shot and the second, and accidentally dropped there, and it results in my death, of course. So that's not very nice. So off the spawn, I'm gonna have very hard times trying to. I wanted to try to deal some damage close range with a shotgun, failed in that attempt. Probably quite a big mistake to even go for that. And here is kind of nice because I can drop down behind Etty and I'm going for some damage. I think the big items were just taken. So, and I did quite a lot of damage there. So this is actually kind of a nice move because he did take the red armor, but because I'm able to spawn on the other side of the map, you can see I can quickly get the weapons and I can get some pressure back onto Etty. So the problem comes here that Etty was able to get the yellow quicker, and I basically just completely fail in my attack. So it ended up being kind of worthless. But I think there is merit to that shotgun play if the follow-up is played better, more positionally with more positional awareness. But regardless, so I'm getting kind of murdered at the moment. It's 5-1, and I'm just trying to figure out a way to survive. Etty's just, kind of converting on his control and getting some of those frags off the spawn where, I can't do a huge amount, which is good work by him. And so now I do manage to spawn over at the yellow side, and I get the yellow and rocket rail. Don't have an LG, and I'm just trying to play it cool. Just trying to play it slow right now to try to figure out what's going on. And you can see I had no idea where he was, but because it was so silent, and it was kind of odd that it was silent when I was already this far out on the map, because this is kind of where he should be, it kind of sprung to mind. And if I rewind, 5. It sprang to mind that the only place that he should really be then is either waiting for a red, and I know that's very, very unlikely because it should have just been taken, or he's waiting for, like, on the mega, or trying to bait, trap the teleporter, which is kind of a sign of play out of control. And you can see there he is actually at the mega, so I peek over, and he's going to go through for the attack. I'm going to try to use his pillars. I managed to get a nice rocket out of the, dancing around the pillar. And that's like the really nice thing about these pillars there. They are quite small. And also there, managed to catch Etty again. So this is like my kind of nice out of control play to get myself back in it. And it just came from some sneaky shots, basically, and catching Etty out. And I only saw a pixel there to rail there, so it's a pretty nice shot, but that was able to win me the mega as I pushed Etty back. And with the rocket jump, I knew that he was weak, and that means that he's likely going for the 50, which likely means that he's around that area. So that's why I made the rocket jump, because even if I don't make the rocket jump, or even if I do make the rocket jump, I can peek in and maybe get an angle on the rail. So this is now some control for me, and it's 3-6, which is kind of nice. So again, just pressuring, managing to catch Etty as he picks up the rail. I wanted to take this duel here because I know that I just have to hit one rail here, and Etty has to hit like two or three. He does manage to hit two, and now I'm kind of in critical condition. And I managed just to barely hit that. I don't even remember that, but that was pretty lucky that I managed to catch that right at the end. Because I got the kill so late, it enables me to get really good position in the center of the map. And I kind of want to bait this. Like, here my idea is just to bait this, because if we think about the situation where I drop here, okay, so everyone knows mega spawning, we can see it up on the spot. I know Etty's above it, so Etty's looking to try and get the guaranteed damage, which I can't really avoid if I go and take it, but I already have 123 armor, and so I'm kind of healthy. Why would I want to take that then if I know I'm going to get damaged? And maybe even he gets some, you know, a second rocket onto it. You know, it doesn't really make sense for me to try to take this if I don't have to. It makes more sense to try to bait him and try to give it up for him so I can damage him instead. So there's really no rush to try to take it. So that's kind of the thinking here. I know that I'm fine with leaving that up, so I can just instead play, you know, walk up the steps a little bit, get some more damage here. And now before the fight's already begun, I've done some damage to him, and because of that, he feels committed to go for the drop. And because I've already done damage, it makes my fight even easier. So this is like a kind of a nice move, and I'm quite happy that he doesn't die there, because it enables me to kind of keep my control going. And every time he pushes out on the map, I get a little bit more damage, and he's in a bit of a weakened state still, so it's kind of tough for him. And so here I decide to leave the red up, because I know that there's no possible way for him to grab it. And if I was going to go for the red, what happens is I give up the opportunity to pressure him and deal damage. Maybe get, because I might get, you know, an angle. I might get, you know, just one shot, and if I hit that shot, that can put me really far ahead at no cost. So you don't need to take the red immediately there, especially as I don't have to rush back to be in position for Mega. So he takes a rail duel of me, and it trades one for one, which is really good for me. Unlucky for him, he does miss that second shot, and I'm able to go for the drop down there, and that's fine, taking that damage. The trade is like, I don't know, 25 damage to me for me and 100 for him, but I get the Mega, so it's fine. A rail as he is dancing around the red armor area. I think he doesn't know when the red is. And there you go, I managed to get the pressure shot. As I go into pressure, I managed to hit the shot rather. And I managed to get the red armor like back in time for the red. So that's really good. So far it's pretty straightforward. The whole game plan is basically just position and pressure. And whenever you can leave items up in control, you kind of do it. And you just gotta try to outsmart them and try to hold good positions and never let them get on items before you. And go for damage and positioning over the items in most cases here. That's kind of what my game plan has been. So here again, you know, I'm going for the pressure, and a really nice rocket there by Etty. And here I'm abusing the weapon advantage, because this is another great thing about positioning, and when you're in control, is with positioning, you can abuse the weapon advantage like massively. And he does manage to get the red armor, which is kind of bad. I'm forced to, I have to hit at least one rail, and I do manage to do that to make the fight easy for me. And he kind of, he didn't have the LG or anything really to battle at that range with, so he kind of got taken down by weapon advantage again. And here, of course, he's going to go for the rail. I missed the shot there, but that's okay. And going to drop down onto Mega. I don't know if I mistimed that or what, but my timing is pretty bad at the moment because I just started playing again. But, oh, okay, there you go. I do manage to grab that Mega after all. So here is a situation where he should have a little bit of armor on him, and I'm not really super secured with my armor stack. So I get quite lucky in that he messes up the jump, giving me an easy shot, and that wins me the yellow without even taking damage. So now I'm again like quite ahead going into the 6 minute mark. So again, it's about positioning and kind of catch Etty there. And again, poking in. Now this is a risk. This is a risk. Because, okay, let's look at this again. So what happens, this is usually where you want to stand, because you have to teleport to get position again. If you go here and drop down, you're committed. So what happens is, now if we look at Etty, if the Mega is coming up, or if the red is coming up, I think which the red is, he can get there first, and he can take it, and I can't really do damage to him. And if I try to chase him, he has a good opportunity to hit rockets defensively. So this is a huge risk. This means that you have to hit the rail. And I decided to go for the risk, because it's I don't know if it's justified to go for that risk. I don't think the red is spawning immediately, so I think it's okay. But you gotta realize that at least that there is a risk there, as far as positioning is concerned. So then we're back to this situation again where I'm just poking in, trying to deal as much damage as possible and provide as much annoyance to him as I can, trying to control his weapons as much as I can. And again, leaving the red up. Because you don't need to take it, you can just go for pressure instead. You can see, like, I have an opportunity at another shot, miss it, but so I'm giving myself opportunities all the time. And again, Etty's trying to get out of there, and I managed to catch the angle that he tried to use to escape that kind of area, or the angle that he tried to use to get out onto the center map. So here's if we rewind here and see why I made the rocket jump. So just grab the red that had been left up for a while. So what I'm thinking here after I poke is that the most likely place for him, because this is the safest place for him, is the high level. So if I just rocket jump straight up from this angle, I should be able to catch him really well here. That is the thinking. So boom. But he was actually on this level, but he had just dropped. So the timing was kind of unfortunate for me, because I could have gotten a really nice fight with that rocket jump. And it's a kind of like, you should make rocket jumps like these because you have the stack to do it. And you see he does drop down though, and he actually gets the better out of the situation, because not only do I damage myself with a rocket, but he hits a rail too. So this is like a kind of a good situation for Etty, but he needs to string together some more shots or trying to trap me somehow. But that's the thing, you want to make sure that when you're in control, you don't... Okay, so I do the same move, this is the same principle. I felt like my stack is good enough compared to Etty's here, so, and I knew that he just went up high, so if I rocket jump up here, I can probably catch him with a good fight. So this is all down to execution in the fight now. So I actually guessed right, and I decided to use LG, not hitting the best LG ever, but it's okay. Do manage to get the kill regardless, and at a very key time as well, because the Mega just spawned, and... I missed a shot on the red there, but it's okay. I've got position, got the weapon advantage. How can he fight against the LG here? He can't. There is like, I lost almost nothing there. So that is totally fine. And you can see off the spawn, just going straight for the pressure. Again, I want to rewind because I want to show you the options I had. So managed to get the kill. Boom. Look at the ammunition. I'm very aware that I'm low on LG right now, but I'm just going to go straight for the teleporter. I don't go for the LG first because I know that I have at least one rail, I have three rockets and a little bit of LG. I just need to do some damage. I don't need to have like full ammunition. So, and I'd be wasting time if I went for the ammunition. So instead I went straight for the teleporter, and here, lo and behold, there is Etty. And I managed to use my my low bits of ammunition to actually effectively steal away the yellow while still doing damage. And I still have a good... It's like kind of like a pattern on the items. So even though he gets the red again, he still doesn't have the LG. And this is like still a huge issue for him, because I keep getting these spots for the LG, which are really good. And again, he couldn't really fight back and deal damage there. So now we've gone up 9-6 with 2 minutes left. So this is really, really good. And I wanted to rocket jump up higher, but I messed it up. Which is really annoying. I wanted to get in for pressure from high very quickly, but that didn't happen. So now again, it's just a case of positioning and dealing damage with these good spots. So I'm leaving the red up here again, because again, don't need to take it. Feel a little bit pressure to take it there because he's actually kind of close. Again, we can rewind here. So what is the most dangerous thing to me here when I'm taking the red? It is Etty who's raiding from that angle below in the choke point. So what happens here? You just do a drop. He can't see the drop. And then all of a sudden you're in his face. So it's a very, very standard move, but very effective, because he feels very pressured to do something at the red there. And it just results in basically a free kill for me. And trying to go for some mid-airs there, not going to connect those. But I still have a good situation despite losing out on the damage, because I got good positioning. He's going to pick up the Mega. I just have to hit a rail there, missed the rail. So now Etty's got a chance on this red. If he has an LG, if he had an LG here, it'd be really, really, really good for him. But he does manage to hit the rail, which is really nice. I returned it though, but Etty will get the frag nonetheless. So now with 10-7 and 1 minute, I should be able to hold on to this in theory. Like I should just be able to just like kill the clock for 60 seconds and just play the corners and so on. I have a yellow. Okay, he got rid of most of the yellow. So the yellow actually ended up being kind of a problem. I tried to get out there with a rocket jump, didn't work. And Etty's gonna kill me. So again, now it's 43 seconds and I gotta find a way to survive. So looking at this situation, it's kind of hard because you're kind of trapped in this position. It's hard to get out of this. I'm not actually even sure exactly how to do it. I mean, I decided to go for a rocket jump to circle back around for the red. Actually, that was a really smart move. And the funny thing is that look, I forgot that I did that. And looking back at this demo, I couldn't even suggest that that is something, a cool move that you should do. And really, let's look at it again then to try and understand why that actually popped into my head. Because this game is so fast that intuition is really important. So I take this rocket launcher, and I know that the red is coming up, but I know that from that position I can't get it. So what I want to do is trick Etty into thinking I'm doing one thing when I'm doing something else. So I go this way, and he's going to think that, oh, he's going to drop down to the mega. But let's think what happens if I drop down to the mega. I'm in a position where I'm very exposed to a lot of damage. If I do this, as I do, I don't take much damage. He does see me, so he can go for the shots. And I'm prepared. I just want to rocket jump out of there. Now, this is really bad for me. So let's go back. The entire philosophy here is that I don't take damage. So that was fantastic. All I have to do now is kill the clock. So all I have to do is try to avoid him. So I hear him move, and I have the hubris to try and peek over. Why would I do that? I have no rail, I have no LG, I have no weapons that can deal damage instantly at distance. And he goes up the jump pad. Of course he does, because he wants to get the kills. And he has a decent stack still. So this is a huge mistake. I could have just, again, let's just rewind. Let's see what should have happened. So rocket jump out. So I should just wait here. I should just wait here for sound cues. That is often how you play this situation. You wait to see what their move is first. But no, instead, I take way too much damage, like 40, 50 damage there. I try to get away with some rockets. I've managed to kill a bit more time. I'm going for the mega, I'm crazy. And Etty hits the clutch rail that probably won, or rather won him a situation where he can tie up the game. Although he still has to get one more frag, but it's 15 seconds and I have no health and I'm stuck, I'm trapped, there's nowhere to go. So Etty managed to tie up the game because of a series of stupid movements from me, for sure. I think this is kind of one of those situations, like my game to lose. Afterwards, Etty did like say the same thing, that I kind of threw the game away. I definitely agree. But there's still overtime, and so let's isolate the situations. So this situation here, I've got the rail, the rocket, I can hear the LG humming from Etty. So peeking out to see what's going on is good, see his position, and manage to land one rail, and I'm just defending the choke point here. I'm happy to die here. Like, I'm happy to die here as long as I get hit two rockets. So that's what this is. It's like standing your ground on a choke point because you know that you can get the first rocket and likely the second follow-up. He does go for the mega. I managed to miss that second easy rail, but it's okay. I'm doing okay surviving out of control so far. And this has allowed me a little bit more breathing space. Another good rocket, another good rail, and another good rail. So let's just look at that again. Often because I'm doing this more than I normally would, just because I'm trying to understand what the hell I'm thinking. Because I'm like, what are you doing? So get the yellow, and I know that I've already done some damage. Okay, so this is, look at this rocket. That rocket is good. That was a good rocket. That justifies doing this. Flick rail. Okay, hit the rail. Now I know we're on even stack. The problem here is that I'm actually, one rail will actually kill me. So this is actually kind of a bad move to go for. Let's think about this. I've done a lot of damage here. If I just go through the door on the left, we'll have like a somewhat even battle for the red armor. And that, I think that's actually better, because I have a slightly better position to deal that to do that from. Because if you look at his position, he has to go through the teleporter. So I should have an advantage in the fight if I just go left through the door to the red. But instead I decide to just jump straight at him with the rail like a crazy person. And all right, it worked out, I guess. In the moment, sometimes it works. And Etty's trying to hold this doorway because this is really good for LG. But I pull the LG out as well, and I got a better stack, so I'm going to win this situation, forcing Etty back. So I'm going to go for the frag here, and I managed to get it. So now I'm 12 to 10, and I got a minute left in the game. And I managed to get some great damage for free onto Etty, and I missed the mega. This is still okay. Still okay. Just got to watch him using the teleporters. And this is really smart from Etty. So the red is actually coming up. What situation does Etty want? He wants like a fight where I'm on the same level as him. So how does he accomplish that? He tricks me. He makes me think that he's going to go through the teleporter, and that I'm like, oh, I can go to the red now. So, and oh, look, he jumps straight back. And now I'm actually in the position he wants. And this is a much better fight for him. So the only way I can win a fight like this is by using this pillar and using the rockets blind and getting really fortunate. So I'm trying to do that as best as I can. It's proving quite difficult. And eventually he does like kind of weed me out, and I do very well on the damage, but I still at the end of the day I die. And I miss that jump, which is really annoying. He gets a bit of free damage. Very difficult, and now I get caught at the red, and he does pin me, and I die. So, alright, pick up the rocket. I can go aggressive here. He knows he's weak. Oh, again, too aggressive. Let's look at the positioning here. First rocket good, second rocket miss. Okay, why would you do this? Look at this. Look at this from his perspective. There is absolutely no way I survive after I peek out this far against CLG on just 100 health. So it's a very, very, very big tactical error from me. And that's going to give him the next frag in this overtime. So again, let's isolate the situation for how it is. So I'm down a frag. That's a problem for me. And I'm going to go for the risky play with the plasma gun. And it actually worked out. I did a lot of damage with the plasma. And I'm trying to catch him kind of peeking for some damage through there. Maybe expecting that I had gone straight to the red, but no. So I'm trying to find Etty. He's got to be on the upper level. There he is. It's just about chasing now. It's just about chasing, and of course, I don't have enough time. So, well played from Etty. I definitely had a lot of opportunities to win this game. I'm definitely going to put a lot of it down to my, my rustiness, because I haven't been in out of control situations, or rather the holding on to lead situations when out of control for quite a long time. So definitely going to take a while to get back into the routine there. But you know, from watching the demo, what I can say I learned is definitely how to stop thinking about opportunities that result in anything but my own survival, because that's kind of what was happening there. And that's kind of an instinctual thing that you kind of have to curb. You have to say to yourself, all right, let's quell the instincts here, the kind of, because this happens to the very top players. I've called players out on this before, in face it cups and whatnot. Sometimes opportunities for damage present themselves to you, and you're just like, oh my god, this is too good to be true. You go for it, and of course you'll die, but you deal loads of damage. But in that moment, the only way to win is to not take a situation like that. But your instincts take over. They're like, dude, this is a really good situation right now for damaging your opponent and getting the kill. But you've got to have the mindset to think more about the long term sometimes. So that's you know, one of the things I'll have to think about more. But generally, it was a fun game. And thanks, Etty, for the games we played today. And I hope that was in some level informative. I think I did play well positionally most of this game. I think the segment where I was in control was pretty good. I'm pretty happy with that on this map. But it was just the out-of-control play that really needs a lot of work as well. So GG, and I'll see you next time. Hope you guys enjoyed.